You see, one of the most profound statement in one of the ancient scriptures that our country has, which is part of the Vedanta philosophy, it says, Aham Brahmasmi, I am the universe. So when human beings are identified as the center of universe, then I think all models of sustainability that we're talking about, whether relating to environment or to business or to any enterprise, really must begin and end with the human being. You see, whether we like it or not, all enterprises, all endeavors that human beings have been doing since the time, since the world came into existence, the people came into existence, is primarily centered at the human being. Whatever we're doing, any sustainability factor. So let me, ladies and gentlemen, and my dear young friends, give a very contrary statement to what you've been hearing the whole day. You've been hearing about change and change and change and changing economic scenarios, sustainability, etc. But let me make a very categorical statement. And I won't be surprised if I shock the imagination of most of you here when I make this statement that in this big, wide universe, nothing ever changes. You see, there's a very interesting French quotation which says, plus ça change, plus c'est la même chose. Now, translated in simple English, it says, more things change, more they remain the same. You see, in a very short perspective, we can certainly talk in terms of that the changes have taken place. About 20 years ago, we used to use a fixed telephone instrument. Now we're using mobile phone. That's a change. But my dear friend, let's be very clear about that. These changes are very heavy, having in a very cosmetic manner. There's a lot of semantics involved in this. But if you look at the largest perspective, you see, we are, the historical evidence which is available today is really of the modern era, which is about 2,000 years old, when you talk about before and after Christ. So, but mind you, the civilizations down the line in this, when we talk about the age of universe being a couple of millions years, then 2,000 years is a very short span of time. Now, in this particular, especially during the last 100 years, we probably have seen a lot of changes. So we are completely overwhelmed and completely swamped by the fact that a lot of changes have taken place. But mind you, let me just give you one simple example. You see, in the Vedic era, one statement which used to be talked about was Jivema Sharada Shatam, which means I should live for 100 years. Today, after so many years of medical intervention and medical support, the average longevity in this world is not more than 68 years. We really haven't reached that pinnacle of development and fantastic kind of level of achievements in medical, in astronomy, in physical science, and all over, in the era which we are not even aware of. So I don't be under any delusion that the era that you are living in, several changes are taking place. Changes do take place, of course. You know, the quality of life improves. But I'll ask you a very simple example. If we human beings are going to be the center of any kind of model, whether it's a business model or an environment model, let me ask my young friends here this question. Ever since the anthropological evidence came into existence that we moved from the monkey to the humanoid, we were on first on all fours, then started rising, then became completely erect. Ever since that, which is good about maybe a couple of million years back, have the human being changed even one bit? Have you changed? Has the body human structure undergone any change? Was it that men used to produce children in previous areas, now women started doing it? Hasn't happened. Human aspirations, human desires, human lust, human angers, and all those negative and positive emotions haven't undergone a change. So the simple point that I'm trying to make is, let us not be under any delusion of completely covering ourselves with the concept that yes, changes are taking place, changes need to take place. Of course, they need to take place, because the quality of human life has to improve. But let's not forget that unless we concentrate and focus on the growth and evolution of human being as a human being, in terms of the process of evolution that must inevitably take place, any change that takes place outside will be purely cosmetic in nature. Now that, let me bring you, when I talk about an example of human body or human system, then one very important corollary that I can extract out of it is that when you talk about sustainability of any model, then the most important thing to my mind today, which is not being practiced by the people world over, is a concept of equality and concept of equity. Any model, business model, is not worth its paper is written on unless it talks about in very, very strong, unequivocal terms, unambiguous terms about the concept of equality. You look at the human body, you look at your body. Every part of your body must receive nutrition.